ये बताओ, रात को रोटी खाओगे? इसी हिसाब से आटा गूंदूंगा। चपाती खाओगे रात को? अच्छा,
ये काम करना है, रिकॉर्डिंग करना है ये। मतलब मैं ला के छोड़ दूँ।
Hi guys, welcome to the session. Hope you guys can hear me. Please type it in the chat window whether you can hear me properly or not, or facing some problem. I can see Pushkar and Ritesh. Hi Ritesh. Yeah, okay, Pushkar says yes. Thank you, Pushkar, for your response. Ritesh, please reply whether you can hear me or not. Hi. So you guys can hear me properly, right? Okay, great. Thank you so much for your response. Okay, so moving ahead, Pushkar had one question which we are going to take in a class. Ritesh, do you have any query in regards to our last class? No queries. Hope is it clear to you? Things we have discussed. Okay, great, great. Thank you. So yeah, I'm going to take up a query from Pushkar. He asked that there is Google Keyword Planner. Hi Deepak, welcome to the session. Hope you can hear me properly. Okay, so you want to know about things like content management system? WordPress? Ritesh, you want to know more about WordPress? CMS. CMS is content management system. So content management system basically helps you to develop websites. Okay, so there are many content management systems available like WordPress, Wix, and Joomla, Magento, OpenCart. So these are the content management system where in our classes we are taking WordPress. Hope you have attended the class of WordPress. Yes. Have you attended our first class of WordPress? Okay, great. So any other doubt in regards to CMS? Ritesh, do you have any other query? HTML is actually a language. It's a language to write, you know, it's a coding part. Abhiram, welcome to the session. Can you hear me? Please type it in the chat window whether you can hear me or not. Hello? Were you facing any problem while joining in? Yes, yes. HTML is basically a coding which helps to develop the website. Earlier, when CMS system doesn't exist, then people used to develop websites on HTML only. And it is still used. Okay. Abhiram, I have shared the recording also with you, which you can hear it in your sweet time. Definitely, I can brief you what we have covered in the last class. Sure. Hi Gaurav, welcome to the session. I hope you can hear me properly. Yeah, okay. So they have the requirement of HTML. No, not a problem, Ritesh. HTML is basically a coding language. My voice is echoing. Somebody is on. Okay, yeah. So yes. Any other doubt you have, Ritesh? Okay, great. So Gaurav, can you hear me? Hi, hello, welcome to the session. Hi. Do you have any doubt from a past class? No, no, you didn't miss anything. We were just having the questions from the past class. That's it. We haven't started yet. Yes. Okay, so do you have any queries? Sure. Okay, no queries. Thank you. So Pushkar was having one query in regards to Keyword Planner tool. He used Keyword Planner tool and he faced some problem. So Pushkar, now can you please tell me where you face the problem? So this is the keyword planner. When you reached on keyword planner tool, this is the home page, okay, where you land up. Then click on search for new keywords using a phrase, website or category. Okay, click here. Now tell me the product area for which you are looking for keywords. Pushkar, please respond in the chat window and let me know the keywords for which you are looking for the product for which you are looking for the keywords. Is it a food related? Is it a restaurant? What? Potatohouse.in. I'm not being able to understand by this. Pushkar, are you there with me? Pushkar, you there? He's not responding right now. Okay, we will take up his question later on in that case. Okay, coming back to our class, let's do a quick recap that we have covered in our past class. Okay, guys, please tell me about on page. What is on page? Okay, now he has. So Pushkar, you want to tell me about the product for which you were looking for the keywords? Okay. So what should I type here? Cold storage. Food cold storage. Okay. Guys, in the meantime, please type in what is on page. Is this your website URL? Potatohouse.in. Okay. Category will come in food and groceries. So is it like household supplies or food? Food. Okay. So we have selected food. Here, baked goods. Is it meat and poultry? The kind of food? No. Okay. So can you just select anyone from these available? The type of food? Vegetables. Vegetables. Okay. Prepared food? Because it's a cold food, so must be a prepared food. Okay. Frozen food. So yeah, here we have got frozen food. Yeah, right. Frozen food is right, I believe. So you must be targeting India, right? Okay. So now click on get ideas. So when you click on this will come when you click here, when you are on the keyword planner, then you will land on that page only first. Search. Keyword is not available for this. Just system has just found one. You want to share your screen with me? Yes, you're right, Deepak. Let me, okay, make you. Okay, so you want. Okay, maybe after the class you can, I'll make you the presenter, okay? In that time you can share it. Okay, guys, so coming back to the, sure, definitely. Coming back to the SEO, please, Deepak has responded, only Deepak has responded, like it's an effect on website. Abhiram says on page includes meta tag, meta description, meta keywords. Yes. Okay. Gaurav, any reply from you? HTML also. HTML? Which HTML? You're talking about Deepak. Yes, HTML codes. HTML codes, basically, in HTML, you can write these title, description, and keywords. Okay, so still they will be called as meta tags only, and if your website is on HTML, then you need to write within HTML by coding. So there is a difference. Okay, HTML code is not the meta tag. If your website is on HTML, then you will go to HTML and then write the code of title, description, and keywords. Else, if your website is on WordPress, then SEO Yoast is one plugin which will be used to capture these details on your website. Okay, on page is basically exactly activity which you perform. What is the other name that I have told you about on page? See, it's a meta code, like, you know, this like meta within title. You start with title. Okay, and it's like. So it will come within title, okay? I can show you the code. Basically, even I'm not a coder. So I'll just copy and paste from HTML. I'll just show you that. So let's say when you click right click on view page source. Okay, then let's try finding the title. Okay, so this is the code basically. Can you see this title by iPhone 7? And then you close that title. It's the open, and for close you use the forward slash. Okay, for meta. Description also, let me find description. So this is the meta name, description, and you say buy iPhone 7, iPhone 7 Plus. Is it making sense, Gaurav? Is it clear now? This is the simple code that you write. You can either copy and paste and change the content. That's it. Okay. But if you're making your website on WordPress, then you don't need to do the coding. It's very simple to write a title in description in WordPress websites, right? So we are going to cover that also. Okay. Okay, so what was the other name which we have discussed on page, guys? Any idea? Remember relevancy? Yes. And off page? Off page? Link building, yes. Backlinks, yes. And popularity. Okay. Then what is keyword density? And what is acceptable by Google? What is keyword density and what is allowed? Please answer quickly, guys. We are doing a quick recap. 1% exactly has to be 1%. Yes. So, in 100 words, one keyword should be mentioned. Keyword planner. Hope you guys remember keyword planner that we have also discussed right now. Okay. So this is going to help you to suggest keywords. Okay. Okay. And within on page, you can check keyword density. There are other tools which are available to check keyword density also. I'm going to tell you that. Okay, yes. So within on page, who is going to tell me about title and what are the characteristics it should have? Please tell me. Yes, the content with blue, 50 to 70 characters, exactly. And what else? Yes, correct. Ritesh, correct. Abhiram. End with the brand name. Last is the pipe symbol, exactly. Make sense, guys? Also, use of focus keyword. What is focus keyword? Anyone wants to tell me about focus keyword? Right, Ritesh, you're right. You need to end the title with brand name or the website name, exactly. Use of focus keyword. What is focus keyword, guys? Yes. No, Deepak, that is not the criteria that it should use. Yes, it should use once in title, description, URL, and everywhere. That's the main keyword, basically, main keyword. Okay? Yes, and coming to description now. Description. does description helps in ranking, guys? Right. Gaurav says yes. No, it won't help you in ranking. Gaurav. Only title is going to help you in rank your website, not the description. Okay. Yes, 130 to 160 limit, correct. And use a focus keyword. User focus okay, and we have also done one more tag. Yes, definitely I'm going to show that how to use them. Okay, so next tag, please, guys. Tell me about the next tag. Yes, exactly. Meta. How many keywords we should mention? Five to six maximum, exactly. Yeah, I'm here. Yes, you can put maximum 10. Okay. Exactly. Okay, so we have done till three keywords, right? Any other keyword we have covered? Any idea? Sorry, any other meta tag we have covered? Any topic? Okay, Gaurav says no, exactly, that's right. What else we have done in our past class? Oh, okay, I think, let me just check. My screen is shared, right? Okay. Just a sec. Okay, my screen went on pause. Sorry, guys. Hope now you can see my screen. Okay, great. Okay, cool. So, yeah. What other topic we have covered? Yes, I'm coming to that because we have not covered that right now in this class. I'll be coming to that. So, guys, any other topic we have covered apart from this in our first class? Sorry, in our second class, Gaurav says no. How many tags will be there in total? There are many tags. We are going to cover all those tags now. Okay. Any doubt, guys? We have done some great examples also. Any doubt from the past class? No, Abhiram says no, Gaurav says no, Pushkar says no. Okay, great. So, yes, keyword density, you were asking me, right? Abhiram? The tool for keyword density, yes. Okay, so there are tools available. Okay, I'll just show you. Okay, so this is one document that I'm going to cover in detail. Okay, this is on SEO only, the things that I'm covering. This is one tool to check the density, keyword density. I'm just copying and pasting it in your this chat window. Guys, can you see this? Okay, so here I'm going to type in the website name. So let's say this is my website name, yourcreations.ca. Okay. So I'm checking include meta tags, description, title. So the system is going to suggest everything, okay? And I'll say submit. Okay, so when you scroll down here, you get to see the count of my website. So can you see the word marketing is used 24 times and density is this. SEO is used 14 times and density is 1. So can you see, mostly it is less than 1% only. Only marketing is 3. But here can you see almost 1 and less than that. Okay. So here similarly, used means not clear. Gauru, 1%. Yes, like the word written in the website. This word, we are talking about keyword density. So SEO in 100 words, basically. In 100 words, it is used one time or how many times, okay? So this website is showing you that. So if you take the of two word phrase like digital marketing, the density is this. Okay. So this is SEO book which is going to help you to check the keyword density. Okay, so let me just type in here. Make sense? See, it is showing for all the complete website, okay? So, yes, Gaurav, you're right. We have to check once your website is developed to check the content, okay? So system, Abhiram, the system, the tool will automatically pick the keywords, okay? The important words basically are the phrases. And it will suggest you. So marketing, these are all the keywords basically on which it's showing me. It's showing me on one keyword, yes, on two phrase, one word, two phrase, three phrase. System has actually picked automatically itself. Yeah, makes sense. Okay, great guys. Yeah. So now, as I told you in my past class that today I'm also going to show you the keyword mapping, how we do the keyword mapping, because that is very important for us. Okay. So I'll share the sheet of my existing client, like how we do for our existing client, the keyword mapping part. When we get the order. Okay. So this is my existing client, which is PropChill. Okay. So can you see this Excel document here? This is the content type is the home page. You can see the URL. a form page, and this is the title we have given, the SEO title, okay, and the length or the characters we have given here, 62, and then we have the description, meta description here for this, okay, and the characters you can see it's exceeding, which is not good. 156 has to be the maximum. Okay. But you can go up to 160 also. Target keywords. Target keywords. These are the keywords for this home page. Just 160. Yes, not beyond that. But till 156 is good. Okay, so target keyword, these are the keywords that we have given, and this is the focus keyword for this particular page, which has to be used in description. Can you see Indian real estate is used in description? It is used in title also. Yes, is it making sense, guys? Okay, great. So this is how when you actually work for your client, you have to prepare all this in this manner so that even your client gets a clear picture what we are doing on. So here, other pages, internal page. Yes, yes, definitely I can share, Gaurav, this for the reference. Yes, this is for the same website. So can you see this is for the home page? Yes, with all the students, I'm going to share this. Then it is for the internal page. Okay, one of the internal page of the same website, which is what's different. Okay, then this is the title that we have given. Okay, then we have given, this is the description we have assigned for this page, web page. And this is the characters of the description. And these are the keywords we have assigned for this web page. That is their page in their website, within their website. So yeah, client's website. Because they do the comparison of the properties. They are into real estate property business. So they show the clients or the online people the comparison between different properties. So that's why their page name is what's different. For each page, you can see here, for each web page, the complete website. For the complete website, we have to do this work. Can you see this? Only then, you know, it will make you also clear that what you are going to do, and even client will also get a picture. Yes, for this page, you are writing this title. If client wants to make any changes, then he can make in the same sheet. Okay, and he can also suggest some description if there is any difference, and the keywords also, and also focus keyword. Yes, and it leaves a great impression also on the client that yes, we are really putting hard effort. Yes, this is called keyword mapping, guys. Keyword mapping. So as I told you about description, title, and the keywords, so you have to map all that. Make sense, guys? Yes, yes. Storing all of them is known as keyword mapping. Not storing, it's like mapping. You're mapping each web page with the title and the keywords. Each web page is mapped with the set of keywords. Okay. Any doubt, Gaurav, Pushkar, Ritesh? It's a type of index. It's not index, it's a table basically, where we have prepared a complete table and categorized every column. Okay. for each web page we have to do this for a complete website. Yes, keyword we have to track and place for every page. Okay, for every page we have to map the keyword. Okay, because every page is different. Every web page is different within website. Okay, and we need to promote each and every page of a website. So we have to write the keywords, title, description, and for each web page, basically. Yes. Shall we move forward? I'll just share it right away only so that it shouldn't get missed. Within this sheet, it's a second sheet, okay? Within this, Propchel, Meta, refer the second sheet, okay, guys? Refer optimization template, the second sheet for the keyword mapping. Yeah? Download this first. Gaurav, are you receiving my emails? Okay, great. Okay, guys. Shall we move forward? Oh, okay, sorry. Okay. Now not getting text what you written. In which? Okay, guys. So yes, coming back to tags. So now we have done title, description, and meta keyword. Okay, let me show you where we enter these tags. Okay, for this, when we create a website on WordPress, right, then there is a plugin we need to install, which is called SEO Yoast. SEO Yoast. Have you guys heard about this plugin? No. Okay, this plugin. Okay, Gaurav says yes, he has heard. This plugin will actually help you to do the SEO activity. Help you to do on-page SEO of your website. Okay, so just to showcase you, as Abhiram was asking me where we have to do this, right? So Gaurav and Pushkar, have you seen how it comes? As you know about this, have you seen earlier? So let me visit to an existing page. Okay, just know about the plugin. Okay, so these are the pages of our website. Okay, so here when I click here on about DMP, one of the page. After installing the SEO, you'll get a different panel of SEO on your existing pages, okay, of your website. So here, this is our website. Your page. Okay, so this is the WordPress panel that you're going to get once it is installed. So WordPress SEO by Yoast. Here you get to see the focus keyword, right? Okay, I'll tell you how to install that. I'll come to that. Okay, so this is the SEO title and this is the meta description. Okay. And you can write in the keywords here. Make sense, guys? So when you write the SEO title, it will be showcased like this. Okay, and meta description. Yes. And now how to install it? You guys can go to plugins here and click on add new. So it is very easy for WordPress websites to do the SEO. Now here you can search for the plugin, which is SEO Yoast. Search here SEO Yoast. Okay, so here SEO Yoast is there. So you can see it is, as it is already installed, so it is not showing me the option to install now and it is already updated. So it's not giving me that option. If it is not installed on your WordPress website, then it will show you this option to install now. Okay, like this install now option will come, which you are going to click. Clear? Okay. Any doubt, guys? Yes, Gaurav says yes. Pushkar says yes. Abhiram says yes. Okay. Great, guys. Thank you so much for your response. Moving ahead. Any other query, guys, which you want me to address right now? No. Okay, great. So now, after title, description, and meta keyword, there is other tag No, keyword mapping is not a tag. Keyword mapping that you have to do. Okay. Yes, you will not call it tag. See, I have written here, it's not under tags. Tags are these, title, description, and meta keyword. Okay. Keyword mapping is basically an exercise that you need to perform to map the keywords for each and every web page. Okay. So now next keyword, next tag is meta robot. Have you guys heard about this meta robot? No, Pushkar says no, Gaurav says no, Ritesh says no. Okay, not a problem. So here, okay, before covering this meta robot, because we need to tell you the process of Google, process of storing the information basically. So, you know, whenever a new website is made, first step is done is indexing of that website. Have you heard about the spider? Google spider, web spider? No. Okay, Google has a spider, okay, on the web network. Once your website is constructed or built and live, then Google spider will come on your website and index the complete website information. Okay. Each and every page will be indexed. You understand what is indexed? The information is gathered or a Google database is made. Indexing means, yeah, database. Creating database. Okay. So Google basically create its data. Whenever a new website is created, its spider or web will come. Yes, collect the data, exactly. Index the is the word is indexing for that, exactly. Yeah. Okay, index the complete website. Okay. So once it is indexed, the second step is storing. See how to do the indexing. Google will do the indexing. Okay, they have got the spiders with them. Who will come on your website. It's a software basically, okay, which we call spider. Okay, we also call them robot. We also call them web robo or robot or spider. These are the words, or crawler also. Crawler, robot. These are the words which are given to them. They are going to come to your website and crawl your complete website or index the complete website data. Make sense now, Gaurav? Is it clear? Okay, then once the information is indexed, they will store the information. Okay. Sorry, before storing the information is processed. Okay, the processing will take place. Once the data is indexed, Google will process the information like where the data or information will be stored. Okay, basically the categorization of the complete website will be done. Getting it clear, guys? Any doubt till here? Because if this is clear, only then robot you're going to understand. Gaurav says no, it's not clear. It's like processing the complete information they have got, because they need to categorize also, right? So based on that only, they will showcase the information. so that they can show the accurate results. Okay, like when the data is crawled or indexed by Google, processing will help to secure the data fast and show the accurate results. Kostha Sharma, one question, is it compulsory to give pipeline in title? No. Kostha Sharma, welcome to the session. Is this your first session? It is not compulsory. It is not compulsory, it's just a good to have feature. Okay, sorry guys, there was one question out of the way right now. So moving ahead, okay, and then the data will be stored at its right location. So that Google can quickly show the relevant results. Okay, this is the backend process actually, which happens by Google. Google takes care of this complete process because they need to have the all information with them. Okay. For that, they have the web spiders. So they do the web indexing, complete a website indexing is done for that. After which the information is processed so that they can categorize the information. So for example, I'm just giving this hypothetical example. Let's say the website is on education business. So if they have a different education business websites, the different category will be there for those websites, okay? And for food related or restaurant related website, they must be having a different category for that. And based on that indexing only, the information is quickly showcased to us. Okay, because Google needs to have the complete database with them. And how they are going to store that database, right? Otherwise, they're not able to show us the results. How will you get to know whether Google has done these things or not? Okay. There is one way actually to know that. There is a tag, which I'm not remembering right now. It's like if your website is, let's say this. This will only help you to showcase that last time when the crawler comes to your website and crawled or indexed. Okay. There is one tag which helps. I'm not remembering right now. Shall I get back to you on this on Wednesday class? There is a tag definitely, which will only help you to know the last it came. So that the website, and there is a code which is there right now. Very few people knows about this, and right now I'm not remembering it. We have actually worked on this, but right now I'm not been able to recall it. Okay, I'll get back to you on Wednesday after referring to my past. Yes, definitely. I'll tell you about this. Okay, so let me write in my homework that I'll have to get back to you on this. Just give me a minute, guys, please. Okay, yeah, sure guys. Yes, it will keep coming on frequently basis, okay, and they keep on checking your sitemap. Okay, we will cover the sitemap later on. Sitemap is also very important part of SEO. You know what is sitemap, guys? Okay, no. Okay, sitemap is basically in every website. Mostly the websites have sitemap where they give all the information about their web pages they have in their website. So this Google will visit the sitemap of website and check whether any new page is added or not. Okay. So whenever a new page is added, then it is compulsory for companies to update their sitemap if they actually want Google to index that. Making sense? Gaurav says no. Okay. You want me to cover right now or later on? How you want to go about that? You want me to cover sitemap right now? Later. Abhiram says later. Gaurav says repeat. And Ritesh says repeat. Okay, so I'll just cover sitemap right now. Okay, so here. So I'll just show you this company example. Many companies, like almost every company has a sitemap, okay? But the name they have changed. Earlier, the web page name is sitemap only, but now it is not sitemap, but they just display the old pages of their website. It's taking a bit time to open. Default.asph. No, this is just the page, website page name, not always that works. Okay, so here either the company will have a different web page altogether by the name of sitemap, okay, So here, can you see this information here right now? Here we are giving all the web pages which exist within the website. All the web pages you can see here in one window. Make sense? This is called the sitemap of the website. Okay. So what Google is going to do is Google is going to read your sitemap of your website. So whenever you add a new page, a new web page to your website, you have to make sure that your sitemap is immediately updated by that web page. So let's say these are the web pages existing. So now I also add a new web page here in the website. Okay. So then I also have to update the sitemap of this, of that web page. Make sense? And let's say if I remove any existing web page, I have to remove it from the sitemap also. Otherwise, Google will keep indexing that web page, which is not more exist. Making sense, guys, now? Because Google will not come and, you know, visit each and every page again and again. So sitemap is the area which will help Google to read all the web pages which exist. So whenever a new web page is added by a company, they will update their sitemap accordingly. Okay, make sense, guys? Please respond. Not getting response from, okay, Gaurav says yes, Pushkar says yes, okay. So there are two ways by which you can update. One is the manual way and the second is the automatic way of updating the sitemap. Okay, guys, just a sec, I have to put my laptop on charge. Okay, yeah. So there are two ways by which you can update your sitemap. One is the manual and the other is the automatic. In automatic way, what companies do is they just put a schedule. Have you guys heard about the schedule? Job schedule? They put a schedule to update their sitemap if there is any addition of web page. That is all automatically handled in that case, okay? And many companies go for the automatic way only so that it shouldn't be missed, right? And some companies do it manual. So if they add a new web page, they manually update the sitemap. Okay. It's only about a web page. If you're making any change to your existing page, let's say if you make a change to this existing page, the content, if you change, then it shouldn't be affected. Okay, then you shouldn't update here anything. But if you add a complete new web page or new URL here, then only it should be updated, guys. Making sense? Okay, Abhiram says there was some connection problem. Not a problem. Okay. Gaurav, is it getting clear? Okay, please go ahead. Sure. Coming back to Meta Robot, guys, now. Okay, just forget sitemap and everything. We are going to cover that sitemap later. Or in today's session only, which we have already covered, but I'll still give you a brief of that. So Meta Robot is basically a robot. Here, within this, we give two indications to robot. One is no follow, and the other is no index. Okay, so I'll cover no index first. Let me write this later on. No index. No index means that you don't want that page to be indexed by robot or the spider which is going to come on your website. So as I told you that in Google Spider is going to come and index each and every web page of your website. So let's say the page is not ready either, or you don't want that page to be indexed because you're not going to use that page for SEO purposes. Okay, in that case, you just write no index tag. Okay. So here, if I'm going to show you the example. Let me see if I find one. Let it open. Is it clear that you don't want spider, web spider to index your page? Okay. Example. Okay. Let's say this is one of our websites. Website where we have just creating a new page. Okay, so your creations, let's say. This is the website where we are creating a web page, such as for a domain, which is only for users' purpose. Not, I don't want anyone to come and index that page, okay, like Google. I don't want to do show it to SEO people. Okay, in that case, I'll say no index. Here, still not open. See, it is saying index. Index means you have to index. But right now, this tag index, if you want to index, then you don't have to write index any longer. But if you don't want a page to be indexed, just in that case, only write no index. If it is nothing is written, that means it is indexed. Google can index. SEO like? I didn't understand your question. Will it be in SEO? This is a part of SEO only. Yes, no index. Yeah, that page will not be SEO'd in that case, because Google will not have any information of that page. Make sense, Abhiram? Yeah. Okay. And the other is no follow. This will be used in off page more. This link, this tag is going to use in off page when we are going to learn about link building. Okay, then only this tag will be clear to you more. Right now, I'll just tell you, there are pages like, have you seen Wikipedia? There are so many links given within that website, okay, which can be either within their own website or outside website, right? So if we don't want a Google to come and, you know, follow that link, actually we should cover this in off page only, right? Then only it will get clear to you guys. Okay, we are keeping this for off page. Otherwise, this will not get clear. When we come to off page, then we will complete this. Okay, no index is clear, guys. Yes. Okay, great. So now there are some header tags. Header tags, you know, header tags, when you write a document in Google also, you get to see heading 1, heading 2, heading 3. Till header 1, 2, heading 6, there are headers, right? So when you create a website and you specify heading 1, which is introduction, then you use header 2. Okay, these are also help you in ranking your website. If you use all these header tags when you create a website, because it adds value to Google, it gives value to Google that yes, if you're mentioning header 1, then yes, it is a focus word and more attention to be paid on H1 words, then H2, H3, H4, till H6 is basically helps you in ranking your website if you're using the headers. Make sense? Because when you write here also in Word document, then also it becomes more structured and more organized way. Yes. When you use header 1, header 2, header 3, header 4, It looks more structured. Okay, here, okay, I'll just show you the example. Header one, let's say when you this is header, this is title. When I say heading one, can you see the font size is changed? So similarly, when you write in website, within website, so let's say, I'll just try and show you if I find something. Can you guys hear me? Slide can't be reached. Okay. You can see like online reputation management header because it's written in different. You can see the boldness, okay, and this also you can see full service digital marketing agency. This is the title, then this again the header, okay. So this is how you add headers, and Google is actually value that because that makes your website more structured and organized. Make sense? Okay. Now, next we have is canonical tag. Canonical tag, guys. In within your website, so here let's say this is okay, when you create a website, VM Pachala. So when you write the content of your website, let's say this is pages, I'll go within pages. So can you see here, we can here change the header, just heading one, heading two, heading three, four, five, six. When you write, just change it. It's just giving you six options, heading one, heading two, heading three. Make sense now? Much clear? Yes, okay, great. So now let's come to what is perform, like pre-formatted. That means system has pre-formatted for you. You don't have to format, like you don't need to select the hair, you know, the kind of text you want to change it to. You don't need to select the this size of the font. That is called pre-formatted. It is already pre-formatted for you. Just select heading once, Google will automatically set the format basically. Clear? Okay, canonical tag. Canonical tag. Do you guys have any idea? Have you guys heard about this canonical tag earlier? No. Okay, yeah. So basically, let's say when you create, there are big websites like Amazon, Snapdeal, you know. Even with small websites, this can happen. Like you end up creating two web pages with the same content. There is a possibility, right? Two web pages with same content, okay? in that case, what will happen? Like, you don't want Google to get confused looking at two pages, and Google will see feel what page to be indexed, right? If Google see two web pages of the same content, then what web page to be, you know, ranked or SEO'd? Okay. In that case, what we're gonna do is we just mention canonical tag. We put canonical tag to intimate Google to index this particular page. Okay, the page which you want to index by Google, then you have to put canonical tag on that page. Okay. And there are chances that it will be with the same URL, Okay. And then if, let's say, these two pages of same. Okay. Then again, I'm having the same page with the same URL. Okay. So in that case, I will, let's say on the second one, this I want Google to index and not this one. Okay. Or use this for SEO purpose. Then I will put canonical on this page. And then Google will work on this page only. Make sense? So here I can show you canonical tag if there exists. Okay, so can you see this reference for your reference that Google says this to be used? Oh, sorry, the which page, website? Yes, Amazon. Might be a possibility that same pages, two web pages are created with same content and URL, everything same. So Amazon has indicated this to be used by Google, canonical. So this is the code that we write for this. This is for duplicate content which is created within your website. Okay. Make sense? Yes. Okay. Great, guys. Lastly, very important. Alternative text. Alt tag, or it is also called alternative text. Okay, basically this tag is used for the images. Okay, so if you write any text within the image, then Google will not be able to read it. So there is no point writing a content within image. Okay, when you attach any image, then please specify the alt tag. Okay, that means Google will be able to read the caption. Okay, so here I'll just show you how it comes in this document. This is meta tag which we have covered. See this. This is the image, and you can use the alternative text here to specify what this image is all about. Okay, so when you attach any image, you can specify the alt tag so that Google can read it within your website. Sure? Clear? Yes, great, guys. Okay, great. So let's do URL naming also. So URL has to be is very important part. So it shouldn't be used any special characters. We can't use any special characters or space between characters in URL. Okay, it's better to use focus keyword in URL. So can you see here, focus keyword here is used Apple iPhone 7 within URL. So make sure that URL is also contain keyword, focus keyword. URL naming. So URL naming has to be done keeping certain things in mind, like no special characters to be used, such as @#$, okay, or no space between characters, as you all know, no space, and use of focus keyword is important. Okay, guys, make sense? Any doubt? Guys, any doubt that in the things that we have done today? Pushkar says no. Okay. Focus keyword is good to put. It will always add value. See, nothing is mandatory here. No hard and fast rules defined by Google. But things which will actually help you to gain ranking or the position in search result page, all these things, if you follow all these things. Okay. So I have covered the keyword analysis part, like you can use keyword planner tool to do the keyword analysis. Keyword mapping, I have shown you the document, how you can do the keyword mapping. And the title tag we have covered. This is the title tag, the content which comes in blue color. Okay. And then the meta description we have covered. Right. And these are the characteristics. Use of pipe symbol, use of focus keyword. For description, there is 130 to 156 characters. Okay. Just revisioning it. Focus keyword again in the meta description is mandatory. URL naming again, that no special character, no underscore, no space between the two words. Okay. And then use of focus keyword in the URL naming. Alternative text or alt tag is basically image tag where you specify. If you write any content within image, then Google will not be able to read it. So it is good to add alt tag there and specify the specify about that image in the tag there. Okay. Then header tags is important. Heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, which I've shown you in the WordPress also, how you can do it. Keyword density we have talked about. Okay, it has to be 1%. If you're not following the rule, then it is called keyword stuffing, guys. Keyword stuffing. Okay. These are the tools where you can check the keyword density, which I have shared with you. Sitemap, I have explained you. Okay, how what is sitemap and how it is going to help you. If you do manual, then this is the URL where you can update your website sitemap. Okay. This is the way. Then off page. Off page, we are going to start in our next session, which is Wednesday, guys. Any doubt from today's class, guys? Please raise your questions if you have any. Okay, sure. I'll explain sitemap in detail in my next class. We will start with sitemap and then we will go on off page after that. Exactly, guys. You need to practice these soon. If your website, have you decided the theme, Gaurav? From themify.me, themify.me. Once your website is ready, because practice will only make you perfect. Yeah, I'll definitely do cover the WordPress. Just waiting for you guys to be, you know. Have you spoke to Srishti? Okay, what she said? Pushkar say she didn't give. Okay, let me ask her what's the reason behind. In the meantime, please select the theme also, Gaurav. Have you selected the theme from themify.me? Pushkar says website is made. Okay, where? Is it made on WordPress, Pushkar? Okay. I'll ask her to give you a call back, Gaurav. Not a problem. Okay. Yes, they are paid themes. We are going to give you free. You can just select. And let me know which one you want. Just share the link with me over an email. I'll give you. Okay, yeah, thank you. And we have Ritesh. Ritesh, what's your status? Abhiram is going to do later on, right? Yeah, okay. So Ritesh, you please share your status, the website status. Pushkar says only theme is left. So please select. Okay, sure, you can speak to Srishti. Pushkar, please select the theme and let me know. So Gaurav and Pushkar, please select the theme and let me know. Ritesh, wherever you are stuck, please contact Srishti and then share the status with me. Okay? Either you guys can either WhatsApp me. You know, you do have my number. This is my direct number, guys. Stay in touch with me on WhatsApp. Okay, because at times, there are times when I don't check my emails also. I'm active on WhatsApp. Okay? Yeah. I will be able to do on Wednesday if the theme and everything is finalized. Then I'll show you how to upload the theme, how we are going to customize the content of your website. And then we can take it forward, how we are going to create the different pages and changing the content of the pages. Okay? Okay, yeah. Okay, if that is ready, then we will leave off page for later part, okay? Later days. Okay. Okay, guys, thank you so much. Okay, thank you, guys. Thanks for your time. We'll catch up on Wednesday, same time, same link to follow. Okay, have a good night. Thank you, bye, good night. Thank you, guys, good night. Good night, Ritesh, Abhiram, Gaurav, Pushkar, bye, thank you.